Hey everyone, welcome back to another video on React Native Expo. In this video, we'll be discussing useContext and how to use it in React Native Expo projects. We'll also walk through a step-by-step example to help you better understand how it works. What is useContext? useContext is a React hook that allows you to consume data from a context provider. Context provides a way to share data between components without having to pass the data down through props. How to use useContext in React Native Expo? First, we'll create a new React Native Expo project. Open your terminal and type. This will create a new React Native Expo project called Context Example. Once the project is created, navigate to the project directory by typing. Next, we'll create a new file called useContext.js in the root of our project directory. This file will contain the context provider that we'll use to share data between components. Inside useContext.js, we'll create a new context using the createContext function from React. We'll also export this context so that other components can use it. Now that we've created our context, we can create a component that will provide data to the context. Let's create a new file called app.js in the root of our project directory. Inside app.js, we'll import our user context from useContext.js. We'll also create a new component called app that will provide data to the context using the user context provider component. In this example, we're using the useState hook to create a new state variable called user and a function called setUser to update the state. We're also rendering the user context provider component and passing in the user object as the value prop. Now that we've created our context provider, we can create a component that will consume data from the context. Let's create a new file called mycomponent.js in the root of our project directory. Inside mycomponent.js, we'll import our user context from useContext.js. We'll also use the useContext hook from React to consume data from the context. Thank you. In this example, we're using the useContext hook to consume data from the useContext provider. We're also rendering the user object as text. Finally, we'll render the MyComponent component inside the app component. In this example, we're importing MyComponent and rendering it inside the user context provider component. Now if you run the project using npx expo start, you should see a screen that displays the name and email of the user. That's it for this video on useContext in React Native Expo. We covered what useContext is, how to use it in React Native Expo projects, and walked through a step-by-step example to help you better understand how it works. I hope you found this video helpful, and don't forget to subscribe for more React Native Expo tutorials.